Good evening. The anguished parents of two of the children killed in the Devonport tragedy have fought back tears to share memories of their lost angels. Zane Mellor's mum says she's opened some of her boys' Christmas presents as her family tries to come to terms with the tragedy. Mimi Becker reports from Tasmania.
Clinging to her son's school shirt and PlayStation controller, Zane Mellor's mum, Georgina, remembers her little boy.
I just needed to say goodbye to my baby, so my baby Zane.
The grieving mother visiting the growing floral shrine dedicated to Zane and his classmates.
He was loud and proud. He was a gamer extraordinaire. I overspoiled him, but I'm glad I did.
Zane's grandfather coming to see the community's tributes, hugging the 12-year-old's pillow.
He was a fun-loving kid. He loved animals. He was just a gem of a boy, you know. Yeah, I'm missing him terribly.
It's going to be hard because I have all these Christmas presents and we've opened some of them and just sat them up for him.
The mother of Jalayla Jane Marie Jones clutched a photo of her and her daughter, one of the 12-year-old's prized possessions.
Apparently it's Jalayla's favourite photo and she sleeps with it every night. She's a beautiful, young, unique, beautiful girl. She's really one of a kind.
While Peter Dott's family returned to the school in memory of the mischievous Year 6 student, the devastation of losing five young lives being felt across the country as the Prime Minister and his wife Jenny flew to Tasmania, taking a moment, wiping a tear and saying a prayer. Their card reading, "In loving memory of these beautiful children, our hearts break for the families and the community left behind."
Yeah, it's hard to see the pain laid out here, but also joy in the fact that the people have come with respect in their hearts. It's fantastic.
Communities come together, haven't they?
It's just devastating. Yeah, something that should never have happened.
The federal government today allocating $1.6 million to provide extra mental health support for the people of Devonport, as well as trauma counselling and training for emergency services and support workers ahead of next year's return to school.
It'll be provided over an 18-month period because we know support won't just be needed in the next few weeks. It'll be needed for many, many, many months.
Generous, everyday Australians are doing what they can to help, already raising more than $1.2 million online. That money will now be directed to the Hillcrest Community Public Fund.
This fund will help the families directly in the directly affected families as well as the whole Hillcrest community.
In the wake of the tragedy, Tasmania's Education Department has now banned the use of any jumping castle-style equipment at schools until the police and WorkSafe investigation has been delivered.
There will be time to understand exactly what happened. We need to make sure that those processes can take their course.
I don't think as a family we're pointing bones at anyone. The nature of the beast was just out of the box.
Instead, an expression of gratitude in the most trying of times.
I just needed to see what everyone had done and I appreciate it so much, but nothing brings my baby home.
Mimi Becker is in Devonport for us. Mimi, three children are still in hospital.
Dougal, the three children are still in a critical condition, fighting for their lives. Their families are holding bedside vigils by their sides in hospital in Hobart this evening. As for the jumping castle operator who provided those activities on Thursday, well, they've shut down their website and social media pages and aren't answering any calls. Dougal?
OK, Mimi Becker, thank you.